Yeah, I'm afraid Lady Liberty's backwards. Welcome. This is a live stream, so if you hear me talking to people, it's because I'm talking to people in the Fib, and I was going to finish the New York City skyline. And I cut out Lady Liberty the other day, and when I checked my photo reference that I have been using, her arm's on that side. But when I just went to see if I could find another picture to get a, you know, close up, and I look at a bunch of images, and it could just be based on where you're at, but I don't know. Or I wonder if that was photoshopped, because look at this one. That's the same as what she has. I think it's just in different photos. So I'm just going to go with it the way it is, because there's no other choice. Hi, Kathy. Hi, Ella. Hi, well, no, Eileen's not in here, is she? Let me pop out my, I popped it out and then I. So the first thing I thought we'd do is put a base coat on her in the turquoise. And I'm going to use this kind of as my guide. Actually, I think I'm going to use this as my guide where I want the gray to start. And I'm just going to put a line. And then blend down. And she's already covered in the gel medium. So, let me. There she is. And it's kind of a taupe gray. And what I did was I needed her to, she wasn't as big as I thought she would be when I got her home. So I put the rest of the monument that she's sitting on out of gel papers. But this will give a base that I can work with. Actually, I'm going to use the big brush. Yeah, I could do it from the back. Is this, let me click on this link and see what you got here. Yeah, that's a profile from the side. Well, I've seen it in two pictures the way I have it, so she's going to be, she's going to be the way she's going to be. But yeah, I mean, I could, well, if I did the back of her, her book wouldn't be, I don't think her book would be as visible as it is. And this is, like I said, this is just kind of a base coat. Let me get a wet wipe. Yeah, links are open. Oh, you're on your phone, Ella? That's what I do all the time. Hi, Orla. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is base coat of turquoise on there. And what I'll do is I'll come in and clean around the area on the outside. I don't know how detailed I'm going to get on her face and her folds and all of that anyway, so we'll see. Okay, and then we need, just got turquoise in a couple places here, not too bad. And then I'm gonna okay. Would have been easier if I'd had her on the other way anyways, because she would have been facing the same way in my photo reference that I printed. And what I'm going to use is I'm just using a gray. Add some of the shadowing in. Like I said, I don't know how detailed she's going to be. Also may end up using some of the paints and a fine rigger. I thought I had one of these in a script, but I can't find one. Let's see. There are some rear view. Well, that'd be easier because there'd be no face. So let's Because I think it's wrong. I really feel like... Because why would she be... Is she looking out to the ocean or is she looking at New York? See, this one shows her facing. I just think I have the arm on the wrong side. See, because it's where you're taking your picture from, I think, is...
Honey, babe.
I love you too, honey. I think Statue of Liberty's on backwards.
Oh, no.
See, because in this one, sure, her arms, I should have checked more than one.
Well, it could be a cult thing.
They must have photoshopped the other one.
Signifies American distress.
So?
Signifies American distress.
Okay, stop, honey. I'm really stressed out, so you're not helping.
See, it could happen to you.
Okay. I'm seriously thinking. I'm seriously thinking I may have to peel this off. What can I lose? The base would be the same. I'm sure this is what you turned in to see. Yeah, I think the other one is photoshopped. Oh, she's going to peel off just fine, I think. If I get her wet. I don't know if y'all want to watch me do this in a stream. So I may have to put her to the side and peel her and then stream painting her next weekend. I have other stuff to work on. And this is where you need undo. It's kind of like a photo transfer in reverse. You just peel the layers off, soak it little by little. And if I soak it, I'll be just fine because that just picked up. Because there's gel medium. I'm getting right back down to the painting if I'm careful. Hi, Laura. You're going to die. I think the... Well, I not think. I know. We decided Lady Liberty was on backwards in the one photo that I had. That she was photoshopped. So I'm taking her off so I can cut her out and put her on again. Because I can't deal with it if it's wrong. It'll bug me. Yeah, so she's welcoming, like, people coming in. Yeah, it's coming up really well. It was just white cardstock scrap. There's a little layer here of gel medium. But I'm not putting any effort into it yet. Like, it's not really soaked. The moral of that lesson is, oh yeah, I'm fixing it. I just couldn't live with it wrong. It's all good now. Like I said, it's just like doing a reverse photo. And it's not damaging. I mean, for the most part, it's going to cover the same area. The only difference is like the arm. Well, I have another project I was going to work on that's laying to the side that I put aside. So I'm thinking what I may do is, now that I know I can do it, I can do this when I'm in here by myself watching a stream and take my time. And I don't think you'll be able to tell at all by the time I'm done. There's just a little bit of a film right here, but I think I can even get that off. So, let's shift gears. All right, I'm going to move the camera just a little bit. So, if you get seasick, motion sickness, give me a minute. All right. Put our reference photo up. I'll have to print another one to cut. But that's, I may actually be able to print her a little bigger too, even. But then she wouldn't sit on that base, right? And let me, where is Jean? Jean's the one that said she was waiting for me to start. Old sassy pants there. Needs to get in here. Right, let me back the camera out because we don't need to be up close for what I was going to work on. I was going to take this from the other day and I gathered a few things. I need to do like a thank you gift. I met through Facebook and Ancestry.com, I think is how she found me, actually. One of Bob's cousins. She's an Epps. And she was doing research and we were on the tree and she contacted me through Facebook and found me and asked me some questions about Bob's tree. So we've been Facebook friends and she was cleaning out. She quilts. And she sent me two boxes of patterns when she found out and knew that I used them. So there's all kinds of tissue and directions and two big boxes of that from Alabama. So I was going to make her something to send to her that she could frame, and I thought I'd do something that was a sewing thing. So I thought what I'd do is just trim this to start with. Where it is. There we go. So I have a straight edge all the way around. And I pulled some other papers that I thought I would use because, you know, one print's never enough. And I thought we'd build something and then I'd send her this that she could frame. I just want to make sure it'll fit in a 9x12. Yeah, as long as it'll fit in a 9x12 envelope. So we may not finish it. So I'm going to put that there, just some dictionary action. I'm going to cut some of this off. I know I want to use this with the yellow. So maybe if I put that in that corner. I really liked this down in this corner. So I'm going to square that off. And I'll put that there. And I don't care that the print's upside down. I think I'll put it here, but I want to tear a little bit more away because I don't really want to cover the title. All right, and then tear a little more off that. I don't think I'm going to use those. And this needs to be a little smaller, a little less. Square up that edge. Hey, team. All right. So that'll be the background. Jean, Lady Liberty was on backwards. So I have to peel her off and start over again. Okay. And then I have this flower that I cut out. And I think I'm going to use it and put it in the background, like here. And then I'm going to use this girl. And I'll put her here. And then I also had some like a little sewing machine. I don't know. Maybe that's all it needs. And then I have this sticker that I'm going to use. It says to dream. So maybe if I make her stand on that. Hey, at least I caught it. But and I can fix it. I was laughing. It's kind of like doing a gel transfer, except for you're just not transferring anything. You're peeling the paper off and there's no transfer. Okay. I think that'd be cute. I might put this one little dress form on. I'm not going to be able to help myself. I'm thinking about covering up the picture on the dictionary print that's a picture of a dog. With the sewing machine, but just kind of fussy cut a little more. Yeah, I like that. Ella, it's not really my tree. Here's how it started. We go to band practice at the bass player's house all the time. It's her tree. And she posted a picture of her tree. And then a friend of theirs that lives with her posted the same picture and said, we finally got our tree up. Then a friend of ours, who's like her daughter, who's in England, posted a picture and said, I finally got my tree up, and she'd stolen Paulina's picture. So then Ruth, another friend of ours that comes to band practice, posted a picture and said, I finally got my tree up. So I posted a picture of the tree and said, I finally put my tree up. I hope that Paulina's house is far enough away so that the cats won't knock it down. It's really not my tree. It's not at my house. I don't have a tree. So we were all just giving Paulina a hard time and stealing her picture. But it is a pretty tree. And she's got a really pretty white, all porcelain white nativity that's over on the other side that is so pretty. All right, so that's what I'm going to do. I don't think I need this at all. But we were just giving them a hard time. All right. Let's see if I can open that bottle. And I'm going to need to find some white paper. And give me just a second. Okay, and I'm going to use paper for her dress. I'll have to decide if we like this one or this one. It's a little lighter color. Or I have one that looks like it's woven. I think I like the one that looks like it's woven that's brighter. But we'll decide that in a minute. I just need a piece of white. I save all my scraps and use them till there's no more left. Well, we'll use this one. I know there's skinnier ones there, but and we need a brush. that works. Okay. So I'm going to start by, I'll just glue these down right there. We'll put this back there. So we don't put a tree up because of the three cats. Plus, nobody comes to our house. When we moved to Las Vegas, we got rid of all of our Christmas decorations. I had bought a brand new tree that I sold all of that because we just didn't have room in the U-Haul that we were driving there. And I told Bob after that I was done, that no more. We don't have kids. Nobody comes to our house. It was me that put it all up. It was me that took it all down. And then we got the two little mischievous cats, so there's no way. Dogs aren't as bad because you can put it up on a tabletop or something, but with cats, there's just no way. All right. I'm gonna trim the back of this just a little bit where it's not lined up. Perfect. Okay. I'll go ahead and stick this down. Oh, I forgot that I had this. I may use that because all right, and then I'm gonna put our flower on. Or it will look like a flower when I'm done. So I don't know if you saw, but I posted what I decided to do as far as a challenge and a project. I just decided to keep it simple. And so my theme was across the decades. And the idea was that anyone who wanted to participate would do an art journal page or something inspired by that decade, whether it be fashion, colors, music, an artist, an event. They would do a project, and they would, when they post it, just put hashtag across the decades. And we'll do, December will be 1890 this month. January will be 1900, and then February would be 1910. Anybody who wants to do it can do it. There's no pressure. There's no, and we'll just, it'd be fun to see how different people interpret the theme. And I put it on my Facebook page, my personal one, and I put it, and I thought we could tweet it. We could do YouTube videos if we put the hashtag, but there wouldn't be, if you didn't want to, you know, if you didn't want to do it 1 month, it wouldn't matter. Nobody's responsible. Everybody could participate, and it'd be kind of like the Inktober for October, but it would just be once during the month. You do a stream with that theme across the decades. And that way everybody can participate, whether they do YouTube videos or journal or just posting a picture. And it'll just be fun to share. And then I posted, I found a picture of colors across the decades, and I posted that too on Facebook and on Twitter because I thought it was interesting because it showed you what colors were kind of popular during those eras. And I'm sure you could find a different source that would. Oh, that's a cool idea, Sherry. You could just dress them differently each time. I found my first one that I want to use for this month. I'm going to it's probably my downloads, just a second. I'm going to paint them. Because all I did was, downloaded the photo so you'd have the colors. And I thought that it was just kind of cool because it would give you a color inspiration. But even like, Dean, you like to journal with music, so you could pick a popular song from that time. It could be an event. Well, yeah, it's no big deal. If you're busy 1 month and you don't do anything, when we don't do anything. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do next. This is kind of hard to do on camera. Let me move this. But here's how, what I do. I hold them over white paper. And I fussy cut. the image. Right, let me turn her around. Make sure she didn't shift down at the bottom here. All right, and then because I'm going to put her dress on with scrapbook paper, I need to cut out her hand. Little bit of right here take out. Okay, so what I'll do is actually gonna take out this little bit. It's not gonna matter. So what I'm gonna do is glue her down where we want her. But I'm going to keep that arm up. Okay, and then what? Let that dry. This yellow here. All right, I'm gonna just use that a little bit, so I don't need. I could have done that flower side too. That would have been pretty. All All right. Save her body parts there. Rid of the scraps. Save the dress. Let me get rid of these real quick. And that extra paper we don't need. What I'll do is I'll put her dress on. And that'll look more like a hand when I'm finished. Okay. Put the lid on that. Let that soak. Yeah, I have to save her body parts as a reference. Have to refer to them. All right. Hey, Dorothy. Dry this real quick. And then we can start putting in the details. I touched that with my sticky hands and I shouldn't have. Well, that's a good idea, the water brush for sealing envelopes. Laura, that's a really good idea. Okay. And to make sure she's not tacky, that she's dry. Everywhere. So I always start with the skin. I stuck my hand in that, in her neck. I need to make sure that's coated, or the marker will rip. It's going to look like she has a scar. In fact, I need to be prepared. She may need a new head. Well, what I'm afraid of is where it tore right here, it'll look like she has this big scar growth on her neck. So we can give her, we can redo that. Give her a new head. It was only that easy. All right, we still need that. I'll put those away because if those poke you, it's some serious business, my friends. All right, so while we're waiting for that to dry, I'm gonna start down here on her legs. And I just go, this part, I still just go over the shoes. I don't worry about any of that. In her hands. She needs a little dry. Another coat there. All right, and then don't worry about the hair either, because it's gonna be darker than that skin. All right, and so that was the light flesh. And then what I usually do is, this is a cinnamon color. I come in. And kind of hit the edges. I gotta turn it. And I can just kind of add some shadows. Get a baby wipe. And then it on this side, same thing. Till I get them the way I like. Sometimes I come in with a little bit of a medium flesh. All right, so that gets her legs done. Really bright tonight? Yeah. Just a second. I'll just tilt. It's glaring because of the... Is that better? Let me zoom. I'm going to go ahead and zoom the camera in a little bit too. And let me go ahead and turn. Let me adjust. Let me see something. It's the glare on this. I've got them tipped up. It's still, there's this one bright spot, right? Okay, let's try this. Let's try doing it the opposite. Is that too dark? That took the glare. That's better, isn't it? It's not too dark. Okay. Okay. And I'll move you in closer. Oh, yeah, I can see. I'll move you in closer when I... do the... more of the details. Come in and I'll hold this up where you can see it a little better in just a minute. get some of, there's some places where I need to get the yellow. I'm gonna wait on her neck. And face, I always do that last. Decide. Okay, this dress has definitely did she open a door, Bob? Tay-Tay stealing socks again. Okay. There's no place to get it from. Well, there was one in my bedroom, Bob, that she'd gotten earlier. Okay, so all I'm doing is kind of adding some shadows in for the fabric. There's not a lot on this dress, line-wise or button-wise. And I think I am going to take a little brighter yellow. Okay, so that gets her dress done. She had an easy little dress. And then I take a gray. Love you too, honey. This is not embossed. It was a sticker, Orla, that I had, an old scrapbook sticker. And I'm going to add a shadow in, and I can even add, sometimes I add a little bit of a shadow under the dress. And it just kind of helps her kind of step off the page. I even sometimes pull back a shadow. And then I'll put a little bit of one back here. Okay. So let's give her some shoes. I don't think that's the brown I want. It's a darker brown I want. Actually, it's just kind of an illusion of shoes. It's not. I'm gonna keep that because that's gonna be part of her hair. All right, so let's put those aside for later. Don't need that. We need to work on her flower. Let me find my photo reference. Because I may need to put in some white paint. It's not a pen. It's probably a download. Oh, I know I still have it. Well, would I have gotten rid of it? Oh, there it is. All right, yeah, it was a watercolor photo that I was using as an inspiration. And I think I wanna just scribble in some white. Really need to buy a new one. There it goes. And I'm just going to do an illusion of the center. Work my way out. From that, okay, I think that will do. And then what I'm going to do is put some petals in. trying to avoid getting too close to that wet paint for right now. All right, and then let's see. Let me turn it upside down here for me. And I'm not doing this exactly like the picture. I'm just using it kind of as a reference. Add some coral in some places. Thank you. All right, then let's come back in with the... Actually, I'm going to come in with some real dark burgundy. It's in a script pen. Maybe too soon to do that. I also want to come in with some black or gray because it's real dark in this. Center here. Take this. Wish I had this color in a brush. All right, so I'm gonna bring that darker color. Back in and add another layer of that. The other thing I have that I'm not trying is I'm not getting what I want, maybe a purple. To blend in with that black. These are the pit pens, yeah, over the gel medium. Liking the texture I'm getting and the depth. Okay. Well, I think it resembles a flower now, at least. clean my hands. What we're gonna do is go to the we'll check, see if these are 109. They're same. This will just stick to that. Why? Did I put in there? All right, let's go brighter in places. And I think I'm even going to go with what did I do with it? Not an orange I was looking for is what I'm I thought I had it out. It's too peachy. I guess this is the closest thing I have to an orange. And it's a script. I thought I had an orange. And I'm not pushing real hard. I'm just adding some color intensity on some of these. And I guess we'll just darken it up a little bit back here. Like I said, it's not specifically the flower that was on the photo, but just kind of the idea. So let's see, get rid of those. Sometimes these really thin script ones don't want to write when you have the layers built up. Right, is I'll just add in some real faint black sketch lines here and there. And it gives it that drawn, you know, it looks like it's drawn. I don't. Yep, last week of break till school, and they take tests all week. So, pretty much they'll be in lockdown mode. So we have 4.5 days. And then the semester's over. Okay. I'm going to pull back a little bit of this. Clean up just a little bit where the black got a little too heavy on the yellow. Back in there. I teach fifth grade math and science. So they're ready, I'm ready. I think I want to put that right there. Since we're done with the flower, what I'm going to do is put a coat of the gel medium over. You don't have to, I just like to protect it from being scratched. And then I'm going to clean up the edges just a little bit where there's some pink smears. Okay. So let's take a heat gun to that. My friend doesn't, yeah, their school goes lots longer, but they're off later. We go back the Monday after New Year's, and the kids come on Tuesday. Oh, heat gun. Okay. Get rid of all that. All we need now is her face. All right, let me. Yeah, it kind of reminds me of a hibiscus too. Let me move the camera in. All right. So, this is where I usually wish I had the face colors in a script tip. I do want to go around this down here. I'm just going to go around this little piece of paper I put on there. Just to bump it. Okay. I don't think I'll need gray. Well, no, I do want gray because I'm going to make her hair. All right. I'm going to cheat tonight. Because it helps sometimes just not struggle with it. All right. So her little chin will be right in here. It'll be right here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do her hair black. I'm going to put a little gray. Actually, I'm going to go in and do that first. So that'll give me kind of a base to work her hair. And I'm going to switch to a brown. Sorry guys, I'm not watching chat. All right, and I'm gonna kind of lighten that. I'll get where it came off here. All right, So that gives me a pretty good base. No, it's not going to do that. I'm going to come back with the brown again. Fill in. And then I'm going to come in with the white. All right, let me let that. I'm gonna hit that just a little bit more. In a couple places. I'll let that dry. I'm gonna come back and work on that hair. Get rid of those. All right, and on the eyes, so often they're really just looking downward. So a lot of times I can just give an illusion. And if you don't like them, like I don't like those eyes, I just take them off. All right. Try that again. And then what I usually do is come in with either the bright blue or the green. Like I said, it's really hard because they're so small. All right, and then her nose, I just do a little bit of a, that's the hardest part really with, to me too, is to do a suggestion of a nose. And I take the, I hope my head's, I'm sorry if I get out of frame. And I take the lighter colors. And I kind of move it around if I need to. I kind of just do an illusion. Thinking the nose is too piggy. All right, just a second. Get a clean area baby wipe. Okay. Let's try that again. Cleaner. It's part of the problem. Okay. And I also will put a little bit of a gray to indicate the nostril. Mm-hmm. Oh gosh. All right, let's give her some lips here. Maybe that'll help. And then still not real thrilled with her nose. Like I said, they need to make this pen in a script. Well, I think that's going to have to be it. It's just an illusion of a face. It's not perfect by any means. Let me try upside down. Well, that's about where she's going to end up. Now let's work on her hair again. And it's just a lighter brown. I'm going to come in and hit those white spots. And I'm gonna come back. And put a few strands of the darker this. Okay. All right, let's see, double check. Moonlight. I don't know. Made you look too much like Helmet Head. Okay, let's pull that back and try that again. And we probably ought to give her just a hint of an eyebrow. And this one eye. Okay. So that's her face. I still feel it. I can see it a little better if I turn that other light on. All right, so I need her face to basically dry a little because sometimes the brown and the black will smear. Okay, and I guess we'll sign it. I think I'll just sign it right down under the flower. Back the camera out. I may do a little of that too. Let me clean this white marker that we used. And I just keep working it on my hand. A little of that. I've got it out. And I think I'm going to give the flower a little shadow here and there. Which will also help with the, if any of the reds bleed out, which they did here and there. All right. So let's put that all up. up that flower there a little bit. Move the camera out. I think that's good. For the most part. And I'm going to give her a coat. And usually when I coat the face, I just try not to move the brush and just lay a coat across. I'm not worried about any of the shoe or her dress because they've been sitting there. But every once in a while, the browns on the hair will smear a little bit. That. And I'll take it out and get rid of all her body parts. And I'll save that flower. Let me take it out one more time. You can see all of it. And let's go ahead and give her face a little dry. Set of hair from the brush. All right. She is all done. So I think that'll turn out really cute. I'm not sure if this will work, but you get the idea. This isn't probably a big enough opening. This is a 8x10 mat. Someone's matted and stuff. She'd look really cute in a frame. But it needs to be a bigger mat. Dictionary print's curling up there. Glad this box of, I think she'll like it. Like I said, she quilts and sews, so she'll appreciate the little sewing references. And I thought it'd be pretty to hang in her studio. And it kind of looks a little bit like Christina would have looked when she was younger. From our era. All right. Let me set that aside. This bottle does not want to close. It's time, I guess, to peel all this dried gunk across the top. Let me throw that away. Get a fresh baby wipe. It's 8:30. Work on this for a few minutes, maybe. I don't really know what I'm doing on it, but I know it's going to be rock. Like a cliff, and then some water. So I'm actually going to take and put a line, and then let's see. I want to do a wash. I want to know what'll work. I want to do the moon because it's Moonlight Bay. So that's a mask. That'll be the right size. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and start with the marker up here. Then take a round. Now this, I don't know how it's gonna work with the watercolor, so I'll have to be real careful. As far as how much water I use. I thought I'd try to do a little watercolor on top of the music paper. Okay, and then it's going to be a gray in here. And I'm gonna add a hard line for the window. So I'm going to use a combination of the pit markers. Okay. Let's get a medium. And I'm just, these are just, they're black lines, so I'm just going to go ahead and put them in. I need a piece of scratch paper. This will work. All right, let's put some gray in that window. And then I'm gonna put, this is black, but I'm going to start out with a gray. Can you see okay? This is going to be gray. Lightly pulling some of that gray down, because that would be kind of in shadows. All right, and then let's find the black. This is the black. All right, let's see if we can blend that. All right. front. Now I want to do a like a dusky purple is what I'm hoping. All right, I'm going to take and scribble on the craft mat. I know you can't see it on the black. And I'm going to try picking it up with a wet brush. Hi, Sarah. And see what we can get. All right, I'm going to work fairly well if I get the I'm not really using the gray. Yet, but I'll come in, I think. Come across this. See, direct to paper, they're so bright. I'm gonna have to come in with some gray and blend that out. Bit of that purplish gray in there. And then I'm going to hold this mask across the top. How good a mask it'll be. All right, I'm gonna turn this. Try to turn it without getting in the and I want some of that purpley in the water, so I'm not caring. Okay, so let's And then I'm gonna go back to the smaller brush. I'm trying to get some. Lavender in here. Clean up a little bit where it bled. Okay, so that's not too bad for a moon. Gives a little bit of a suggestion of the moon. And then what I'll do is come in with the gray. My brush wetter. Thinking a little titanium white. Acrylic. Well, maybe that one's clogged. There's more white. This is watercolor, and it's the Zig clean color markers. Okay, but I am gonna add a little bit of opaque white to the moon here. I'm just using my finger. All right, I'm pleased with that. Let's find, I'm gonna keep the gray and the purple out. Let's see, this is a deep blue. Let's see what that looks like on paper. Oh, that's probably what I want to use for the water. Put a line at the top for the water, and then I'm gonna start darker. I think oh, no wonder I don't like this brush. It's not my good brush. That's why it had the horrible purple into this one. Dry just a little bit. I don't want to dry it too much, but I want to let it dry. Just let me hit it with the heat gun just a little bit. Because what I'm going to do is come in here. The three colors that I've used. And the purple. And I'm going to soften those. Okay. Lines are harder than I want. Them to be. All right, I think that's dark enough though. Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in. And take the white acrylic. And kind of make a reflection on the water of the moon. And then I'm going to come back in with the darker color. on the little brush. Okay, you gotta pay attention to this. Is would be a lot easier with the other craft mat. And I'm going to darken that. And I'm just using the dark blue and the gray. Add just a little bit of that purple back in there. Trying to stick the brush in the cap. All right. And take the brush and pick up some of this purple and gray. Okay. And just putting a little white where I had a little too much gray. Okay. All right. And I think I want to probably put a little gray in the bottom of this. Then I think I'm going to add some brown, like a weathered, I'm not sure if this is the color I want. Yeah. Okay. I kind of like that color. I might put some on the lighthouse too. It's pretty shadowed. This up here is just really not necessarily detailed. Okay, and I think I'll go back to that red. That's not the same red, I don't think, but I'm going to do a brown too. Just get a mix. The door. I need a little of this color. Thank you. Okay. Now let's take the brown. Kind of a more of a green to it than I thought. Mint brown. All right, let's here's a dark brown. That brown and pick that up. Kind of do a wash. More water. They get on the paper, they don't blend very well. So they don't blend out very well. They absorb almost like a regular marker. I think I'm going to take, this is a little bit of rich espresso and it's a shimmer acrylic. This is a chocolate. I gotta cover up what I got. Gotta watch my hands too. Shimmer's really pretty on the bottom. And I wasn't liking what I had. There. Kind of darken that a little bit. Okay, and then we need to put a light in there, but we need a golden yellow. Brighter yellow, just a touch in there. I don't know if I'm gonna like that. Clean baby wipe. Thank you, Sarah. I'm gonna minimize some of that. I'm gonna give it a little bit of a glow. And I think I'm gonna come in with a little gold, metallic, and put a little shimmer here and there, like barely a touch of it. I barely have any on my hand. Okay. Okay, let's see all that. May come in with just a little bit more gray to define that. Okay. I think I'm done. I'm gonna square it up because I never did from when it was torn out. Yeah, she's on YouTube, and it's Mixed Media Morsels. Let's see. And we need to sign it. Thinking down here. So again, just a quick little mat. Actually, this would fit in this mat really good. I just would need to sign it someplace different. Let me sign it up higher, up here. That would actually go on there. Like that, pretty good. So that's right side up. Put these up. Thought about putting a little shimmer, since we put some shimmer in other places, on the moon. And I think I'm going to have like a silver shimmer. And then I'll put a little of white pearl. Acrylics also, so let me. Got my hands filthy. And that'll give that little shimmer. I may even add a little right here down the lighthouse. Yep, two things done. Well, I had already prepped. I mean, I'd already pulled for both pieces. I knew what I was gonna do on both. So what I'll do with this one is, let me get some of that. I have that tape. I hate when I can't find things. Maybe it's over here. Two sizes of that tape. Here it is. So what I'll do is grab this from behind, and I'm holding it at the top. And all. This is just artist tape for watercolor. Tape that across. And then down the sides. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, I need to stop the recording.